everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to create a Arduino Dice LED with 7 segment display in Tinkercad. Okay, here is the end result of my project. I'm going to show you how it works. I have a code over here. Okay, now let's run simulation. Okay, I'll click on this serial monitor. Okay, for this program to work, you need to push this button and it will generate a random number over here on the dice. Okay, now let's click the push button. Number one, lights up one here, and number one over here. Click it again. Now it's showing number three. I'm using a random number generator, so the number here are always random every time you push this button. And 6 over here. Okay, let's stop this. Okay, I'm going to show you how you start this project from scratch. Okay, let's go to Tinkercad, and if you haven't got an account, you have to create one. After you create an account, go to circuits over here and click on create new circuit. Okay, now for this project, I'm gonna name my project on top of here. I'm gonna rename it as Arduino Dice, let's say version 2. Okay, done. Now, for this project, the materials you need are breadboard. You need 2 of them. This one here, another one over here. And you need an Arduino. Six LEDs. I'm gonna arrange it as like a number 6 dice. And a push button. Okay, now we need a 7 segment display. This one, display it over here. Okay, now I'm going to connect these wires. I'm going to connect the wires in pairs, as in this one is going to be paired with this one. This one is with this one, and this one with this one. The middle one acts as a solo. Okay, now let's connect the wires. For the cathode negative part, I'm going to connect it to the negative terminal on top of here. So let's connect it. I'll be using different colors for each pair, so it's easy to differentiate later. Okay, now for this one, cathode, bring it to the negative terminal. I'll be using same color for it because it's the same pair. Okay, now for this one. Bring it here. Using red color, same with this one. Okay, now for the last pair, this one. This one I'll be using green. Okay, done. And for For this one, the solo, same thing, bring it to the negative terminal. Yeah, use grid for this one. Okay, now that we're done with the cathode part, which is the negative terminal, now we'll go with the anode part, which is the positive part. Okay, now for the anodes, I'm going to bring it to the breadboard over here. Let's say I'll bring it over here using blue color. It's paired with this one, so we're gonna connect it with the same pin, which is this one right here. Blue. Okay. Now, same thing with the rest. For the reds, we'll be using a new node. Here, red color. It's paired with this one, so let's bring it here. Red color. Okay, now for the green parts. Now for the last one is the green one, the solo. Just bring it to the node over here, anywhere, and make it gray color. Okay, now that we're done with the LED wires, now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring all these wires to connect it with the Arduino over here. Okay, now let's start with the blue wire. Blue one, gonna bring it down. For the blue part, I'm gonna connect it with the number 10 on the Arduino. Let's zoom in a bit. Okay. Make it blue. Okay, now for the red, I'm gonna connect it with the number 9. Which is this one right here, 9. Red color. For the green one, I'm gonna connect it with the number 8. And lastly, the grey wire, I'll be bringing it to the number 7. Okay. Now for the push button, for this part right here, terminal 2B, I'm gonna bring it to the Arduino. Okay, now let's get the wire. I'll use the yellow wire. Same thing, I'm gonna bring it to the number 6. This one. Okay. Now let's see. Okay. Now we need a resistor to connect this one right here. I'll be using 330. Okay. Now set up this wire over here. Now for this one, I'm going to bring it to the ground. So I'll bring it down here. And I'll just put it over here. I'll be using a black wire for this one. Okay. Now, for this terminal over here, 1A, I'll be bringing it to the 5 volt. I'm gonna connect it to the breadboard first. Bring it here. I'll be using this color. Volt, this one over here, same color. Okay, now I'm done with the LEDs over here. Now let's move on to the 7 segment display. For this one, I'll be adding resistors to it so it doesn't blow the 7 segment display. I'm gonna do it one by one. Okay, now let's set the resistance to same as before, 330. Make it ohm. Okay, now let's connect the wires. We will be using the same node as this one, so I'll take this one right here, bring it on top. Now for this one, I'm gonna connect it to the number 5 on the Arduino. Let's bring it here and bring it to the number 5. Is this one? Color, I'll be using blue. For the second one, yeah, I'm gonna change this as blue as well. Wait, I forgot the resistor. Okay, put a resistor here, make it 330 ohm, and connect the wires. For this one, I'll be connecting it to the number 4 on the Arduino. Let's use red wire this time. Same here. Okay, now this one, the middle part is the common. You need to connect it to the ground. So okay, let's get a resistor. Ohm, 330. Okay, connect the wire. For this one, let's bring it to the ground. I'll bring it here. Let's use a black wire. Oh, before I forgot, let's connect a ground wire to the part over here, this node. Make it black. Okay, let's continue connecting the wires of the 7 segment display. This one, I'll be using the number 3 on the Arduino. Okay, leave it as green. Now for the last wire on top here, connect it to this one. Okay, orange. I'll be connecting it to the number 2 here. That's 3 orange, okay. Okay, now for the bottom part, same thing, you're gonna add resistors to every bit. Oh, I need to set this one as 330 as well. Okay. This one. Connect the wires. For this one, I'll use a white color. Connect it to the number 12 on this Arduino. Number 12 is right here. Okay. Right. Now on to the next one. Put this, change the number. For this one, I'll use the number 11 here. Okay, make it yellow. Now for the middle part, it's common again, so we're gonna bring it to this part over here. So let's add the resistor, change the resistance. Okay, this part. Be using pink color, and I'm gonna connect it to the number 13, which is this one, pink. Okay. Oh, for last part here is the decimal place. Ignore this part. You don't have to put any wires or resistance, resistor. Change this as quickly. Okay, now let's see. Is there anything else I took you? Oh yeah, I have to connect a wire right over here. And let's bring it right down here. And connect it to over right here. Okay. Now, okay, let me check this real quick. Okay, now I think we're done. Just have to put in the code. Let's see. Delete this. Serial monitor. Oh, go for text over here. Click on blocks and text. Now, let's clear all this. Okay, I have created a code for this project. You can just use my code, put it on GitHub, and I'm gonna put it on down in the description below. Okay, now let's use my code. Just gonna copy this one. And click on paste. Okay, now we're done with this project. Now let's see, start the simulation and see if it works. So start simulation, open the serial monitor, and click on this button right here. Displays 5, 4, this button. button. This one doesn't light up. Wait, let me see why. I think there's a bit of error here. It should light up this one. It's alright. You can just check my main project over here. On my profile, I share it later. You can copy paste straight from the complete the code. Okay. And I think that's just about it. So thank you for watching. I hope you all to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys soon.